Can somebody say, Dew of heaven? Give it over to you. Dew of heaven. Hallelujah. Mashata bakore mama. The resurrection power, then dew of heaven. How do you mean resurrection power? All throughout for the past 6 weeks, the Lord has been taking us through resurrection power because of the Easter time. That is when Jesus Christ died and rose again. And the Lord has assured us that it's not every good thing. People need to understand when they are praying, they'll say, everything that is dead in my life will come back. No, it is not everything that is dead must rise again. It is only those good things that is dead that must come back again. Hallelujah. And the Lord has confirmed to us that it doesn't matter how far it takes. It doesn't matter how long it's going to take. The resurrection power will definitely bring every good thing that is dead in our life back to life. If only you can believe. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 13 verse 8 make it understand that Jesus is the same yesterday, today and forever. If Jesus healed at that time, the same power is still in operation even up to today. So I don't know your circumstances. I don't know the cancer. I don't know the illness. I don't know the emotional oppression. I don't know the mental oppression. I don't know psychological oppression. I don't know physical oppression. I don't know what oppression could be. Jesus made you to understand that when he was anointed with Holy Ghost and power, he went about doing good, healing to the oppressed of the devil, because the Lord is with him. And I know the same anointing the Lord has given unto us with the Holy Ghost power in this generation. If only we can tap into it and believe, because we are already joined here with Jesus. Whatever Jesus did, we can do as well, because greater works we will do. So I don't know the oppression the devil is bringing. Let me tell you, if you know your right, and you know where you are seated. You are not seated down below with the devil. You are seated with Jesus. As a joint here, we are called joint here at the palace of God right now because of his blood that was shed for us. So I believe that the resurrection power is working. Somebody say it's working. The resurrection power is working. Hallelujah. If I look at it, you don't know how it's going. You may not feel it, but God is working on your behalf. Hallelujah. Shanda ba 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 ba. Resurrection power and dew of heaven. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm just going through the brief of the last time I ministered 2 weeks ago. Hallelujah. And the Lord took us through the woman with issue of blood. Amen. The woman with the issue of blood. She was able to receive the dew of heaven by touch with Jesus. So many people, they are in church. They are not, but they are not in touch with Jesus. They are in church for 20 years, 30 years, but they are never in touch with Jesus. So many crowds were with Jesus there, but they were not in touch with Jesus. They were touching Jesus, but they are not in touch. You are in church, but you are not in church. The Lord is telling us, let your eyes of understanding be enlightened. When you have deeper revelation with God and Rema, people will think you are crazy, but you are already entering a new revolution with God. When that woman of issue of blood got the understanding, got the revelation, there was revolution in him, in her. She woke up one day after all the money has been spent. After everybody has decided
situation, but if you stay in touch with Jesus, my God, the Lord will transform you. The demon that will fall upon you, you will enjoy the water from heaven. The Lord is going to change your life around us. You will be a testimony. People want to hear your story because they know when you were in the issue of blood, but now your life has been transformed.
To get to the poultry. By the time I walk through the path, all my clothes will be wet.
because of the dew. Hallelujah. And now listen. When your clothes are dry, when your destiny is dry, when your life is dry, when you are dry financially, when you are dry economically, when you are dry maritally, you are dry educationally, when you walk through the path of the dew of Jesus, you will get wet. You get wet. So early in the morning, when I need to go to my father's farm, I need to go and feed the hens with the feet. Early in the morning, when I walk through the path, I get wet. I receive the dew. So likewise in the spiritual realm, if we can walk through the path of righteousness, we will experience the dew of heaven. It's a narrow path I normally take to get to the poultry. It's a narrow path. No two people can walk together there. I need to walk through the narrow path as a farm girl to go and feed the poultry early in the morning. And early in the morning, I must be ready to get my dress wet. If you want your destiny to be wet, like I want a farm girl, you must be ready to walk through the path of righteousness. It could be very enjoying. It could be very challenging. But I tell you, it's worth walking through. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, dew generally is very important, crucial for farmers. Because in the tropical region where I came from, when there is dryness, we survive through dew. I remember then, I had an orchard. I planted a bunch of fruits. I had guava, mangoes, cashew, pineapple, papaya. I love to live on a farm. And I still dream to live on a farm. But that's how I grew up with. We don't buy things in the market. We have everything ready made. Even pepper, banana, plantain, we have everything on the farm. And sweet potato, we have everything fresh. I'm a good farmer. I love being a farm girl. I love it. The only thing we do not have then is cow and horse. I never had horse and we never had cow. But every other animal we had. Fish pond, we had big hectares of land with maize. Big companies that does feed. They come to take the dry maize from us, to buy the maize from us. So I was on industrial farming. And I dream one day I can still do that. I love it being on the farm. So I know what dew is all about. If we want to get the dew of heaven, we must be able to damn the consequences. We must be able to take the risk to get in touch with Jesus. Daily in touch with Jesus. How can we be in touch with Jesus? By a prayer. When you pray to a state that even when something's about to happen, your spirit begins to pray. Sometimes when I'm watching TV with the kids, they are watching something, immediately my spirit will trigger and I say, this thing you're watching is not good. I think my life will go turn it up, or change it. That is, when you have a praying spirit, you can easily discern things easily. Your spirit must be sharpened in prayer. Another way of staying in touch with Jesus is fasting. Fasting is when you deaden your flesh to let your spirit emerge. Let your spirit overshadow the flesh. When you're fasting, you're spiritually charged, spiritually inclined. Hallelujah. Another way of staying in touch with Jesus is our service for the Lord. Ask God, where am I to serve? As an evangelist, as a choir, as a preacher, as a teacher, how am I to serve? We can serve in different ways. A counseling, you can be a counselor. You can gather people in the community and be ministering to them, helping them.
Doing good.
Having charity. There should be one way or the other we can serve. stay in touch with you. Hallelujah. In fact, I can't open the chapter of why the purpose and the message for today, but I will go briefly into it. And I know we'll finish next week in Jesus' name. The time is coming. We have more than enough time. Hallelujah. Staying in touch with Jesus, walking the path of righteousness, will make us be able to get abundance of dew of heaven. Hallelujah. Listen, the power of resurrection is already there. But we cannot experience the dew of heaven if we don't play our part. The Lord said to me, I will play my part. But Teresa, you got to play your part. It's a two-way thing. God will play his own part if you play your own part. Brethren, this month will not go on without you experiencing the dew of heaven in Jesus' name. A pastor came to prayer conference, this last prayer conference. And when I saw him rise my spirit, I was led to pray with him. He didn't ask me anything, but I just felt I should pray with him. One prayer point, he's here, his family is still in Nigeria. And I just touched him. I said, in the name of Jesus, within Susan's time, your family will come and join you. He texted me few days ago to say, his family, they're already here. Dream of heaven can come in so many ways. Even some expected things that you don't even expect, God is going to bring your way when the Lord consider your faithfulness. Going for evangelism could be so challenging sometimes. When I still want to sleep, when I want to... The last job I did, I said, listen, I don't care how much you want to pay me. You must give me Monday and Wednesday 2 hours. I want to go and serve my God. If you don't give me those time to preach, I'm not going to take this job. And sincerely speaking, I was giving. For 4.5 months, I will come early in the morning, 7 o'clock. Do whatever I need to. 10, I will leave. I will come to the city, preach the gospel, leave 11:30, resume back 12 o'clock. I did that 4.5 months. Then my manager said, are you not crazy? Even when it was rain, I will go in the rain. I must put God first. Put God first, then God will put you first. Seek you first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Every other thing will be added unto you. It might take a while. That is why God wants you to wait. In the book of John chapter 5, that is the main topic for today. But the Lord brought us back to the woman of issue of blood. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know somebody is here that will testify next week about this deal of heaven. Unexpected money will be coming forth in the name of Jesus. Unexpected grace will be coming forth in the name of Jesus. Hey, Baba, you are not saying
amen.
Unexpected favor will be coming forth in the name of Jesus. Unexpected miracle will be coming forth in the name of Jesus. The dew of heaven, you are due for the dew of heaven. In fact, somebody is here who is overdue for the dew of heaven. And I bet you, not even Prince of Nottingham will hold that testimony. Hallelujah. Let me summarize this man's story. Then we'll continue next week because we share the body of Christ. Then we'll close. Hallelujah. Listen. If there's anything I don't even want to do, it's ministry. As a pastor, I love my evangelism. But God has his way of doing his things. This man was sick for 38 years. Then when the Lord opened my eyes to understand, he's been sick before Jesus. introduce this man to us. Then the Lord will break it down next week. Hey! 38 years he's been in position. The Bible recorded that Jesus passed through that point where the man was at the sick every year for 30 years. Now, let me break it down better. This man in the book of John chapter 5, from verses 1 to 18, he's been sick 8 years before Jesus was born. If I can make my calculation very well. When Jesus was born, Mary was carrying Jesus to the feast that was mentioned there. Because that feast is only meant for the male. But not that Jesus did not see the man. But there was a set time for the dew of heaven. There was a set time for his miracle. There was a set time for him to be touched by Jesus. Sometimes your dew of heaven, Jesus will need to touch you. Some you will need to touch Jesus. Hallelujah. If I begin to break it down now, you won't have enough time. I just introduced this man in general in John chapter 5 to us. Because by next week, the Lord's going to open our eyes deeper about how we encounter his own deal of heaven and how we can be a benefit of that. Hallelujah. Let's be on our feet. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, this month will not go pass by without us experiencing the dew of heaven. This month will not pass by without us experiencing the dew of heaven. This month will not pass by without us experiencing the dew of heaven. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.